Welcome to the manual testing and automation basic session by the software testing help team. I'm Swati. I'm going to be the facilitator for these sessions. I'm a computer science engineering graduate, and I've been a QA for about 10 years now, since 2004. I'm CST and CSQA certified, and I've been a facilitator for the sessions for about a few months now, close to a year now, and we've had like over 200 participants who have taken this session already. So today in this demonstration session, what we're going to do is I'm going to give you an orientation of the syllabus, the format of these sessions, what all is included, and we'll also take up a test topic to give you an idea of how everyday session goes on, right? So let's get started with the syllabus. So we'll start with the roadmap of the entire course. Now, you all must have seen on the website that this is a 5-week class, and we have 3 days a week. Each day session is 2 hours. Okay, now right now this goes on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Wednesdays, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Pacific time. So the curriculum of this session, since we have most of the times our students are from, you know, non-IT backgrounds, and some of them, even though they are from IT background, you know, they are beginners to QA, and some of our participants have already been QAs for a while, but they want to, like, you know, have a class which enforces or reinforces their basics. So we have a good mix of all sorts of students in our class. So what we do is we try to start from the very beginning. Now we try to start from topics that will ease our way into the advanced topics very well. So we start with the software development methodologies. Now, before I explain this, let me tell you who this class is applicable for. Now, this is a QA class. So anybody who wants to or needs to learn QA, this class is perfect for you. So if you are a fresher right out of college, and if you're looking for you know, an entry into IT, and if you're interested in QA and want to make an educated guess as to whether, you know, this is something that you're interested in or not, so this class works for you. And if you've already been a QA, as I said, if you want, like, reinforce your fundamentals, this class is for you. So basically, anybody who wants to learn QA, this class is aimed at them. And there are no prerequisites as such. You know, we do not expect you to be an expert in anything, you know, before you get in here. So it's not like, you know, we're looking for IT professionals or anything. So what we are doing here is we have a QA course, and we also try to, you know, give a glimpse of real-time work that happens in projects, so that if you are new to this field, new to this IT field also, it will be a good exposure for all of you. So coming back to the topics, the first week we have the development methodologies. So here we will talk about the different ways in which software is built. So why does software get built? What is a software in the first place? What are the steps that go into it? And where does testing come into picture? We'll talk about all that in the first week's topics. So as you can see here, we have the V model, waterfall, agile model, all of these models. So the focus here is both the traditional and, you know, the more, how do I put it? The more recent developments in the software development lifecycle. So we have you covered as far as you know, everything, all the methodologies are concerned. So even though we are going to talk generically about, you know, everything that happens in the development process for a project, the focus still is on QA. So even though we try to learn all the stages, we are much more keenly concentrating on how software testers play a role. What kind of activities do we do? So that's the focus is still on testing while we are trying to learn, while we are trying to get the entire IT perspective. Starting week two, again, we are going to go much deeper into the testing process. So we have the software testing life cycle, the main topic that's going to begin in week 2, and that's what we're going to talk about in the next 2 weeks. So all the everything that is a part of the testing life cycle, all the inputs that go into it, and all the deliverables that we create, everything is going to be explained. And the focus of this class is strong fundamentals, at the same time practical application of the knowledge. So everything, both the theory and the practice, is going to go hand in hand. And at the end of the first 3 weeks, we will have everything in our hand that we need to know about the QA field with enough practice. Now, week 4 is again something that will be highly beneficial to you in terms of adding skills to your resume. In week 4, we're going to take up incident management tool, which is Jira, a defect management tool, Bugzilla, a test management tool, Qtest. So not only do we provide you a 100% overview of these tools, a walkthrough, we also give you a test ID so you can, practice working on the tool and gain some skills on it. And in week 2 comes the automation part as well. Now, this class is 100% a manual testing class, but we want to introduce you to the automation topic as well. The reason is, especially when I started my career, when somebody told me that a tool will perform testing for me, it somehow sounded to be, something that is too good to be true. So for those of you who have never seen automation, really happen, or, if you've never, hands-on worked on creating an automation test, it gets very hard to conceptualize, or, this whole automation concept becomes an abstraction in our heads, a big black hole that we somehow can't figure out. So we want to help our students out in cases like that. What we do in this class is, we'll talk about all the theory that leads up to automation, like why do we automate, who automates, what do you need in order to automate, all that, background information. And I will give you an overview, or I will show you how automation happens with the help of QTP. So to clarify, this class is in no way a QTP class. It's just making you understand the automation concepts using QTP as a vehicle. That's all. Now, week 5 is going to be your career counseling, most of it. So in the class, we'll discuss how to create your resumes, what to include in it, what not to include in it, how can you portray your experience in a positive way. If you are from a non-IT field, how do you explain that change? All that we will talk about in the resume session and also the mock interview sessions. So here we'll discuss, things about what kind of questions you can expect in an interview, how can you answer. As far as the technical questions go in testing, there are multiple resources on the internet. But it's about, answering questions that are relevant to your situation. So that sort of thing we'll take up in week 5, and also the certification guidance. What are the beginner level certifications available? What might be more relevant to you? Again, in my opinion, certifications, no certification is a bad certification. So I wouldn't say one is better than the other. It's just about, what would you prefer? It's about personal preference. So I'm going to give out to you all the information about this certification, so you can make a decision as to which one appeals to you better, or which one, fits what you're looking for in a better way. So that's what we're going to take up in week 5. And in week 5, we also, keep some buffer time, just in case we, miss out on any topics, we can just catch up. In addition to all this, every day's session is going to have an assignment, so you get to apply the knowledge that you gain in that day's class. We also have a live project. We provide our students with an application that, you can test and find defects and, perform all the, real-time activities via this application. And then there is the bonus study material that every one of our participants receive. So these are some QA ebooks and ISV QB related material, which is a great value add if you ask me. that's basically how the entire curriculum is going to look like. So let's talk about how each day's session goes on. So the way each day's session goes on is, we break down our session into three parts. One is the vocabulary part. We discuss the main topic. And there is a practical application or in other words, assignment related tasks. Now, every day session, we'll try to do all these three parts. Vocabulary is because, sometimes when we work in a certain field, we kind of, have some words that become common part of our conversations. For example, you might say, when is the build going to get deployed? For a newcomer, build sounds like, what exactly is a build? A build is, a piece of code that is ready to get to, be installed. So those are the kind of words we want to speak the QA language. So every day we will try to pick out one or two words. Again, we also give our students a chance to, bring their own words. So we will have that part where we, get familiarized with the QA language. And then there's going to be a main topic, which is basically, the topic that we are at that particular day. And then the practical assignment. So starting from day one, there is going to be an assignment every single day. So there's a learning curve right from the very beginning of, the class. So that's how every day session is going to be like. So even though the session is for 2 hours, we will have a main topic for our 1.5 hour. And the last 30 minutes, we would like to leave it for Q&A, because question and answers. See, being an IT professional is mostly about communication also. So we want to give our participants a good chance to interact with each other and with the facilitators so that we can, have a brainstorming session instead of this being like a, lecture. So the last 30 minutes is usually a question and answer session. And after the session ends, every day, the notes that we make during the session, which is basically, whenever we are discussing a topic, I like to jot down a few points that seem important. And so the running notes and the video recording of everyday session is going to be sent out to our participants in an email every single day. And these video recordings are going to help you revise the topics. If you need to see them one more time, you can just go ahead and do that. And these recordings are available for our participants for a period of 12 months. So that's basically a little bit of background information about the class. So yeah, there's going to be a vocabulary, there's going to be a main topic, there's going to be a practical assignment. In addition to all this, our students can have set up one-on-one sessions with us. Now, these sessions would be about your resumes. So we have a generic resume class, one day in the class we discuss about the resume, but that's not all. You can, make your resume, send it to us, we will revise it or review it, make changes, and, unless you have until you have a perfect resume, we can, go back and forth on it and fix it and, make it work for you. And similarly, if you have an interview, you can give us a call and we guide our students, that sort of stuff. So apart from all the stuff that happens in class, we have one-on-one sessions also with our students. Of course, we need to schedule them early on and things like that, but we do make that happen as well. So that's about our classes in general. Now today I'm going to take up a topic and give you a brief idea of how the topics are going to be dealt with in the class. So this is going to take like 5 to 6 minutes, and we'll take up the test planning topic. Again, this is only going to be an introduction. So let's get started. Now, we were talking about the SDLC, right? So SDLC stands for Software Test Lifecycle. So this is about how a QA, QA stands for quality assurance. Now, whenever you say testing, it's all about, finding defects. But that's not all what testers do, correct? As testers, we not only find defects, we do activities that help in defect prevention. So basically, since we are so much more than just identifying defects when they occur, we are also about, making sure that they don't occur in the first place. QA, we call ourselves QAs, which is because we do both defect prevention and defect identification. So that's what I mean by, QA every time I call us the QA team. So in the software testing lifecycle, you can say that there are three main, activities. You can just break break it down into three stages. One is the test planning. Test designing. And test execution. See, say you have a web page in that there are like 20 elements or, you know, 20 components or 20 items in it. Now, if you, some components are related to each other. Say, for example, there is a month, day, year. Each one is a different field, correct? You have a choice to choose month, you have a choice to Tuesday, you have an option to choose the year. Now, all of these three fields, they contribute to the date of birth field as a collective, you know, one part field. Now, for us to test the date of birth, you know, for a part of it, you will have to test each of these, you know, elements individually and what they constitute, you know, as collectively. So it's not only about like, you know, checking if whether things are existing or whether, you know, you are able to make a choice or not. That doesn't, you know, that's not only the extent of testing. You will have to plan. You will have to understand the rules. You will have to, like, you know, come up with intelligent situations to test. Only then will the testing activity be successful, correct? So in order for you, for us to do all that, we will have to first understand the application really well. We will have to understand the logic, you know, based on which things are going to be, things are going to get processed and stuff like that. So it's very important for us to understand the logic. So testing does not mean that you have an application and you just, you know, work on it and find defects. This is not how it goes. As testers, we have to, you know, plan diligently, you know, apply that plan or, you know, or use that plan to create our tests and eventually test the application. Only then will we be able to test correctly, identify the maximum defect and provide value as testers. So basically, test plan is the one of the first things that happen in a project. And the reason is because testing is not only about coming at the end, pushing some buttons and finding problems. It's a structured activity that really has to be controlled or managed in a way that the results are always consistent and effective. So basically, test planning is one of the first activities. Now, every activity that we discuss in class, or this basically the whole test planning is a process. Now, anytime we discuss a plan, we try to talk about what is the input, who are the actors, and what's expected at the end of it. So at least these three components. In addition to that, we'll discuss what each process is, when does this happen, how does this happen, and if anything else is relevant, we'll discuss all that. So for that, let me get an Excel sheet and start writing down the test planning process details. So as we talked about, we are going to come up with an input, output, what is it, who does it, in other words, actors. When does this happen and stuff like that. Now, test planning is the first step, correct? So when in the sense, this is the first step of the software testing lifecycle. Who, this is an activity that is led or driven by the QA lead. Now, but then this is in no way an independent activity. This has to be something that the QA team members are going to participate or provide their inputs. So I'll explain that in a little bit. The input for this step is basically the project plan, because the overall project plan will tell you when the project is going to start, when is it going to end, when is the QA phase going to start. So one of the primary places from which we can, you know, draw our outcome and think about what to include in our test plan, especially when it comes to date, number of people, that sort of stuff, we will always test with a project plan. In addition to that, we refer the FRD document, which is the Functional Requirements document. This is to understand the scope of testing. We have to know how much is the extent of the application. Say, for example, There is an application that runs 10 web pages and has probably, 150 features that are implemented on it. So you need to know the size of the application, the complexity of it. You need to do some sort of analysis to come up with how much time it's going to take for us to test. So this sort of analysis, if there was a previous application that you tested or, that as a team you all handled and it had like 10 web pages and sort of, something similar to, a number of features that's close to 150 features. The complex, so basically this is a previous version, correct? So this is some history you've had in testing similar applications. So that sort of experience plus, understanding of the current situation is going to help us plan better in the test planning phase. Since test plan, now the output of the test planning phase is the test plan document. This is typically a Word document. Again, that's not a standard, but most of the cases, this is a Word document that runs over 25 to 30 pages and has all the information that you would require in order to decide how the testing is going to go on. Now, what this process is, so this document is a sort of blueprint, a sort of map that's going to tell us how to go ahead and test the application. Now, if this is a document that's very important, you cannot have it being updated by everybody at the same time or, anybody who has access to it. So test plan is a document whose integrity is very important for the success of the project. That's why it's a document that is made accessible for editing only to the QA lead. So this is an activity that's predominantly led by the QA lead because it's very, very important to have this correct, to get this correct, right? And the QA team members are going to participate and provide their inputs in this activity. Now the test plan will contain information about what are we going to test. Sorry, this probably is more relevant in this section. Who are going to be involved? So what are we going to test is, in other words, the scope of the testing project. Who are going to be involved? The people part of it. When is the testing going to happen? In other words, the schedules. How is the testing going to happen? So when I say how, it means how would you create the test cases? Would you use an automation tool or not? So how, in the sense, in this section you can talk about the deliverables, like are you going to base your testing on test cases? Or are you going to be basing your test cases on, creating an automation test script? If yes, what is the naming convention? That sort of stuff. This will also have information on what is the output that you're going to generate at each phase, how you are going to communicate with each other in the team, and what are the roles and responsibilities of the team members. And how, if you have, there are any tools that you're going to use, what is that? What kind of data are you going to provide for your testing? What kind of, say if you identify defects, how to deal with them? So the defect management process is put into your test plan. And then if there are any risks that your project might run into, those risks are listed, and how to handle the risks, that plan is also made in, a part of the test plan. And then given the time, we would test the product until we find all the defects, correct? But it's something that cannot go on forever. So when the time is limited, and when you have so much to do, you will have to come up with a situation on when to stop testing. See, even today, if you have, like, if you go to, like, any of these popular sites, like Amazon.com, any of those live sites, if you sit down and test for probably, a few months at a time, you're still going to find one or the other defects, because, no software is perfect. So So, but then is it really worth it to sit that much time to find that one defect or to send the product into production is always going to be the question. So a test plan is going to talk about when to stop testing as well. So here we would also have information on the exit criteria. So then the testing is going to happen in the schedules. In addition to this, you'll also have information about the entry criteria, which means when to start testing. You'll also have when to stop testing, the environment in which the testing is going to happen, and if there are any reports or metrics that you're going to collect, that information is going to also going to be a part of the test plan. So basically, these are all the constituents of a test plan. Now, for some reason, this is also an important question. They'll ask you what should the test plan be. Sometimes the question could be in the form of what is the table of contents for your test plan. So they're looking at what are the components of the test plan. So briefly, these are the components of your test plan. Another interview question that comes with the test plan, the topic of test planning is, what is the difference between a test plan and test strategy? Now, as you can see from this, the constituents of the test plan, half of them are managerial stuff, like who are the people, what are the schedules and stuff like that, the roles and responsibilities. So let me just use a different color to point out the managerial parts of it. But some are very specific to the application that we are testing, like the scope, how are we going to test, communicate again, okay, the tools, the data, the defects. So all of these are specific to the application that you're testing. So anytime you're trying to come up with a plan that is technical in nature and that you are going to concentrate on the application being the major focus, those parts of your test plan become your test strategy. So you can say that a test strategy is a subset of your test plan. Test plan will have managerial plus technical information. In other words, managerial in the sense this is project related, technical in the sense this is application or the software related. So all the parts that are specific to the application or the technical information related information, this becomes the test strategy. So in the class, we would discuss about entry criteria in detail. We would discuss about functional requirement document and understanding the scope of it in detail, and the deliverables in detail, risks, risk management, that part in detail, exit criteria. So all of that is going to be discussed in detail in the class. In addition to that, we'll also take a look at a real-time test plan document to get a good understanding of this. So I hope that gives you a good idea of how day-to-day classes go on, and I hope this demonstration will help you make a decision on whether this class is right for you or not. Thank you for your time. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.